an ending form of a verb in Tagalog. Dinalhan niya siya ng bulaklak. Binilhan niya ako ng kotse. Ginawan kita ng website. An-ending form verbs are used in a passive voice wherein there is an indirect object. On my previous lesson, lesson 30, I talked about indirect object. In the sentence, he sent flowers. What is the subject or the doer? He. What is the object? Flowers. If we make the sentence longer, he sent flowers for me. What is for me here? If flowers is the object, me is the indirect object. It answers the question to whom or for whom the action is done. He sent flowers for me is an active voice. It's not very common in English to say the flowers were sent by him for her, because we always tend to speak in an active voice wherein we focus on the actor doing the action. But in Tagalog, it's very common to speak in a passive voice. Object-focused sentence. And how do we translate the sentence in Tagalog? What is send? Padala. Active voice. Nagpadala siya ng... What is flowers? Bulaklak. Para sa akin. So, how do we say nagpadala siya ng bulaklak para sa akin in a passive voice? If it's nag-mag conjugation in an active voice, in a passive voice, it will always have the IN conjugation in front. P plus IN plus the rest of the letters. Nagpadala, pinadala. Without the receiver, if we just say nagpadala siya ng bulaklak, he sent flowers. In a passive voice, this will just be pinadala niya ang bulaklak. Now, if we add an indirect object pronoun, nagpadala siya ng bulaklak para sa akin in a passive voice, P plus IN plus the rest of the letters plus HAN at the end. Pinadalhan niya ako ng bulaklak. Let's try another verb. Dala. No pa. Just dala, which means bring. Nagdala siya ng bulaklak. He brought flowers. Active voice. How do we make this passive? D plus IN plus the rest of the letters equals dinala. Dinala niya ang mga bulaklak. The flowers were brought by him. If we add an indirect object pronoun, nagdala siya ng bulaklak para sa kanya. Active voice. How do we make this passive? Dinalahan is acceptable, but in a casual conversation, we tend to drop the last syllable. So we say, dinalhan niya siya ng bulaklak. Passive voice. Let's try another verb. Bili. Very easy, right? Buy. Bumili siya ng kotse para sa akin. He bought a car for me. Active voice. Passive voice. Binilhan niya ako ng kotse. Active voice. Bumili para sa. Passive voice. Binilhan. Active voice. Nagdala para sa. Passive voice. Binalhan. Third verb. What is do or make? Gawa. Gumawa ako ng website para sa iyo. I created a website for you. Gumawa para sa. Passive voice, ginawan. Ginawan kita ng website. Oh, here, why are we using kita? If you have seen lesson 9, you should not be confused about this pronoun anymore. Kita is the you in a passive voice, and it's only being used when the doer of the action is I. So, kita is from me to you. That's why in this sentence, ginawan kita ng website, the I is no longer needed here. Because it's understood that whenever we use kita, the doer is I. And the receiver of the action is you. Fourth verb, kuha, get or take. So, let's say the dad got an insurance for his kids. Let's use the future tense because we haven't used the future tense yet. So, kuha is an verb. Kumuha, past tense. Kumukuha, present tense. kukuha, future tense. Kukuha siya ng insurance para sa kanila. Kukuha para sa active voice. Passive voice, how do we conjugate the verb? Kinuhaan, past tense. Kinukuhaan, present tense. Kukuhaan, future tense. And then, it's okay to drop the last syllable. Gawa, instead of ginawaan, we just say ginawan. Binilihan, we can just say binilhan. Dinalahan, we can just say dinalhan. Kukuhaan, we can just say kukunan. You can use any of these, it's not a strict rule. Kukuha siya ng insurance para sa kanila. Kukuhaan niya sila ng insurance. Another thing that you need to remember in a passive voice, if the doer pronouns in an active voice are ako, ikaw, ka, siya, kami, tayo, kayo, and sila, these pronouns are no longer doers in a passive voice. These pronouns will become the receivers. That's why here we say, dinalhan niya ako ng bulaklak. Binilhan niya siya ng kotse. Kinuhaan niya sila ng insurance. Ginawan kita ng website. Review. Number one, the unending form verbs are only used in a passive voice, object-focused sentence. Number two, the an ending form verbs are used in a passive voice wherein there is an indirect object, to whom or for whom the action is done. Number three, in an active voice, you will see sa, para sa, mula sa. For example, sa kanya, to her, para sa kanya, for her, or mula sa kanya, from him, from her. If you want to speak in a passive voice, then you will use the an ending form verb. Nagdala siya ng bulaklak para sa kanya. Dinalhan niya siya ng bulaklak. There you have it, the unending form of a verb in Tagalog. This is Dara from Tutor of Manila. Follow me for more.